Here we're asked to multiply and simplify. These are sometimes called special products, which we'll see in just a moment. But if we take a look at the two binomials, notice how one is x minus 7 and the other is x plus 7. In the second example, we have 5x squared plus 1 and 5x squared minus 1. So let's see what happens. Here we'll have four products, x times x, x times 7, negative 7 times x, and then negative 7 times positive 7. So the first product would be x times x, that's x squared. Next we'd have x times 7, that's going to be plus 7x. Next we have negative 7 times x, that'll be minus 7x. And then we have a negative 7 times a positive 7, that's going to be minus 49. If we take a look at the middle terms, we have plus 7x minus 7x. These are like terms, but when we combine them, we get 0. So we're left with x squared minus 49. Notice how the two like terms had a sum of 0. Let's take a look at our second example. Again, we'll have four products. Again, we'll have four products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 5x squared times 5x squared, that would be 25x to the fourth. Next we have 5x squared times negative 1, that'll be minus 5x squared. So we did those two, and then we have 1 times 5x squared, that's plus 5x squared. And then we have positive 1 times negative 1, that's minus 1. Notice once again we have two like terms here in the middle, but their sum is 0, so we're left with 25x to the fourth minus 1. Both of these products were special because the binomials are called conjugates of one another, meaning one of them was in the form of a plus b, and the other was in the form of a minus b. When we have two binomials that fit this form, their product will always be a squared minus b squared. So while this formula may be a nice shortcut, I'm not a big fan of memorizing formulas because as long as you know how to multiply two binomials, you can determine the product very quickly rather than trying to memorize a formula which you may forget. So I do recommend multiplying these out just as you normally would.